Hello students, I am Dr. Aruna Mohan from Delhi University, and today I will discuss about pregnancy, lactation, parturition. In the previous episode, we discussed about fertilization, movement of fertilized egg, zygote from fallopian tube to the uterus, and its implantation in the uterine endometrium, and also hormonal interplay with the concept of synergistic action. One example of synergistic action was menstrual cycle, other is pregnancy. And I am going to discuss one more example of synergistic action of hormones, and that will be parturition, and the fourth will be lactation. In this particular slide, you can see baby in the womb of mother. You can see the placenta, the cord, and also you can see the head near the vaginal opening of the womb. Now, when baby is growing in the uterus, so many changes, the hormonal changes and otherwise, are taking place. This baby is taking everything from mother's body, whether it is glucose, that is food, whether it is oxygen or any other thing, calcium, phosphates, whatever is required for the formation of the body of baby. We know that we have 206 bones in our body. When baby is born, he is born with 206 bones. Mother's calcium goes to baby's body to make baby's bones. If mother has enough calcium, fine. If she doesn't take enough calcium in form of milk and milk products, then she does not have enough calcium to give to baby. That does not mean that baby will not take it. Baby will take it from mother's bones, and mother's bones will become less effective. What I am trying to say, that baby will take everything required to form his body from his mother's body, whether his mother's body is able to provide it or not. So, baby has that mechanism. The blood from mother is flowing towards baby and bringing all the things which he needs. So, that is the work placenta or the cord is doing. Coming to hormones, the first 3 months of pregnancy will be looked after by corpus luteum in the ovary. That means ovary is controlling pregnancy in the first 3 months. In other words, progesterone is taking care of pregnancy, and that is why we called it pregnancy hormone. By the end of 3 months or 90 days, this corpus luteum will start regressing, and that is the time when placenta will take over. And now, placenta will look after the pregnancy. How? By way of producing HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin. Chorionic because it is coming out from chorionic villi. Gonadotropin because it is having effect of gonadotropins. And human because it is coming in human uterus. So, HCG will now look after pregnancy for 6 months. As long as placenta is there, HCG is there, and till that time pregnancy continues. But after placenta starts disintegrating, because it has fixed lifespan of 6 months, then supply of needful things is reduced or stopped, and that is the time when baby should try to come out or struggle out. But before that happens, many other hormones will come into play, like lactogen, like relaxin, like prolactin, oxytocin. Why all these things are happening? These all things are happening because body is conveying message to different parts that baby is about to take birth, milk should be there. Prolactin hormone comes, and this prolactin will cause milk production in the breast. Only production, not ejection. And the hormone will come called oxytocin, which will help in ejection of milk, milk coming out from nipple of the mother. That will be taken care of by another hormone, oxytocin. There is one more hormone, relaxin. To relax the area through which baby will come out, we have pelvic girdle, which is very strong. Now, uterine opening is between or in the center of this pelvic girdle. You cannot move the bones to bring the baby out. Now, this relaxin will make those areas of the bone where vaginal opening is there spongy. The bone will become spongy for the time being, so that head of the baby can slip through it and the whole body comes out. So, relaxin is an important hormone for proper childbirth or delivery, or technical word, parturition. Parturition is an important word. The baby coming out and becoming free from mother's body. As long as it is in mother's body, it can be considered a parasite on mother. A happy parasite, a pleasant parasite, because this baby is taking everything from mother's body. Once the baby comes out, he is not taking everything. Of course, he will suckle milk, which will come out from breast. We follow next slide to understand further details. You can see fetal ejection reflex. It is happening in the uterine endometrium. You understand like this, that baby is in the uterus and endometrium of uterus is keeping it inside safely. Now, when hormone comes, say oxytocin, it will cause downward contraction of uterus. This is called fetal ejection reflex. This oxytocin is going to help in milk ejection later. So, downward contraction will start pushing baby out from the vagina. So, this is done by oxytocin. Expulsion of baby takes place, and at that time stem cells are in the cord that can be collected and kept for varying periods of time, preserved properly, and if required can be used later. Lactation, which is an important phenomenon, means production of milk and feeding of the baby with milk. This is wonderful thing in human body, in human female, that she can produce milk from her body at the time of childbirth and little afterwards also. As long as mother is feeding the baby, the breastfeeding, the next cycle will not become. Menstrual cycle, which you have understood in previous sessions, is an indication of fertility. Ovulation took place, fertilization took place, implantation, pregnancy and childbirth. Now, menstrual cycle will not set in as long as the mother is feeding the baby or as long as lactation is going on. So, it becomes natural family planning method. If there is no menstrual cycle, there is no ovulation, there is no pregnancy. Lactation is another example of synergistic action of hormones because it involves hormone prolactin to produce the milk in the breast, hormone oxytocin to eject the milk from the nipples, and growth hormone for the growth of breast. Milk ejection is a reflex, very complex reflex. Oxytocin helps it, but more it is helped by suckling stimulus, suckling by the baby. If baby suckles the nipple, then automatically the milk will come out. So presence of oxytocin is must, and suckling stimulus is also must. That means mothers should try to feed baby many times in a day, so milk is automatically produced. So that is the milk ejection reflex. The first milk which comes out is called colostrum, which is very, very important. The first milk should definitely be fed to the newborn because it is going to give immunity to the baby. You are aware of the fact that when baby is born, he does not have immune system. And that is why baby is given so many vaccinations, because he does not have much of immunity. The baby is kept so carefully that he should not get any infection because immune system is not developed. But he is born with a gland called thymus, which is present at the level of heart. It will gradually make the framework for immune system, fill it with antibodies and other cells, and by the time the child reaches puberty, the immune system is ready. In fact, immune system is quite well made in the first 3 years, and then it is developed further and it is completed by 13-14 years of age. And after that, the thymus, the gland which was responsible to make it, degenerates. At puberty, thymus degenerates, with the result thymus disappears. And another reason why thymus degenerates is presence of sex hormones. We know at puberty sex hormones become available and they kill thymus. But no problem, our immune system is made properly, and one immune system is enough for full life. But if one is caught by AIDS, what is AIDS? Immune system is damaged or affected. So now if immune system is affected, we do not have another thymus to make another immune system, and that is why disease like AIDS has become so serious. So in the absence of immune system in the newborn baby, the good way to give little immunity is to feed the child with the first milk which contains colostrum, and it will develop the initial immunity for baby to fight with little infections here and there. Not only this, breastfeeding also helps baby to have some good wavelength with mother or with parent, and this baby will have more confidence. This baby is going to be more stable and more composed compared to the one who was not fed with mother's milk. So this is a matter of understanding for all the human females, that when they give birth to the baby, they should feed the baby with the breast milk as long as possible, at least minimum of 6 months. It will also save them from next pregnancy for that much of period, and it will also reduce weight of the female, because there is tendency to put on weight in the abdomen or near the shoulders after delivery. That will be taken care of by lactation. That weight or that growth or that fat will reduce because of lactation. So a female is benefited by lactation, and also the baby is benefited. And lactation is another example of synergistic action of hormones. With this, we come to the end of this session. Thank you.